And this is where I made up my mind. My worry was, how can one prevent Hitler from using his bomb? And I came to the conclusion that the only way in which this could happen is if we also had the bomb and threatened with retaliation. In other words, the concept of nuclear deterrence, which up to this day is being used as an excuse to keep nuclear arsenals, I developed already in 1939. And so I went to Chadwick, the head of the department, and put him the suggestion that we should start the work on the atom bomb. But the point was, and I must stress this from the beginning, I wanted to develop the atom bomb, not that it should be used, not even against the Germans, but to prevent its use. And later other people had the same idea. We began the work on it in England. And eventually we established the scientific basis for the bomb in our work in Liverpool. But later on the Americans took over with the Manhattan Project. And I was invited to go to join my other colleagues to go to the United States, to Los Alamos. Soldiered on there in Los Alamos until I've learned in November 1944 when Chadwick came to Los Alamos and he told me about the information, which he had definite information, that the Germans are no longer working on the project. My immediate reaction when he told me this was, oh, very well, in this case, there's no need for me to be here and I want to leave. So eventually they let me go and I went back to England, and for the next 8 months, I had no idea what was going on because I'm completely cut off from any contact with my colleagues there. It was indeed only on the 6th of August 1945 when I heard on the BBC radio the announcement about the destruction of Hiroshima. This is the first time that I learned that the project itself was successful, and also my great shock that the bomb was used, because going back to the days of Los Alamos, we often would meet sort of at the houses of colleagues and discuss political situation, but discuss the future. We discuss how the bomb should be used. And most of them felt it should not be used against civilian populations. We felt if need be, we should use it as a sort of demonstration, a warning shot somewhere on a desert island and so on. And this is still the feeling which I had when I heard the news, the great shock that it was used directly. So this was a terrible surprise, terrible shock to me. It took me a very long time to get over it. And it had quite a big effect on my life, almost a dramatic effect. I felt I was betrayed as a scientist. My contribution to science was misused, in my opinion. Soon after the war was over, many scientists who worked on the Manhattan Project, who were shocked by the destruction of the two Japanese cities, decided that scientists should organize themselves to make sure that this event would not be repeated. And so a big organization was set up in the United States called the Federation of Atomic Scientists, which is still there, and also in Britain, the Association of Atomic Scientists. We worked somewhat together in our field, trying to influence the nuclear policies of the United States and Great Britain. However, we realized quite early that if scientists were to have any effect, then it's not enough to talk to each other. We will agree with each other. We have to talk to the people on the other side of the Iron Curtain, because we have a Cold War going on, and therefore we have to talk to the Soviet scientists. As it happens, the initiative for this came from a British philosopher, a mathematician, Bertrand Russell. I have been in touch with him quite a lot. He was very worried about what's going on, and he felt that eminent scientists from the world should issue a proclamation warning governments and the general public about the consequences of a nuclear war, and also calling on scientists to get together in a conference to discuss ways how they can avert this danger. And he asked Einstein to sponsor this. Einstein agreed. In fact, the last act of Einstein's life was that he signed this, which became known as the Russell-Einstein Manifesto, in which this proclamation is being made.